In the last video, you learned about the building blocks that make up any workflow. And you saw how Michelle used them to build the foundation of her customer feedback workflow in Asana. If you missed that video, we recommend checking it out first, then coming back. Once the foundation of your workflow is in place, how do you add the handoffs and automation that bring it to life? How do you get your workflow to, well, flow? The answer is to look for different types of movement and connect them to the right features in Asana. The Workflow Builder helps you visualize how these features come together to create a seamless flow of work. As you build your workflows, look for these common types of movement. Initiation is how work starts in your workflow. Handoffs are places where one piece of work prompts another or passes from one person to the next. Intersections are when your workflow connects with other teams or tools. And repetition is where the same actions happen over and over in the same way. Let's look at each of these types of movement more closely and see how they show up in Michelle's workflow in Asana. In some cases, your team manually initiates work, like when you decide to publish a new blog post for an upcoming launch. Some workflows involve an intake process, where actionable work is prompted by input from others, like a request. Intake processes are an ideal use case for forms, which let you streamline and standardize work requests. Michelle's been collecting feedback from lengthy emails and one-off Slack messages. Adding a form to her workflow enables her to collect the same information from teams about every piece of feedback. When a new piece of feedback comes in, Michelle adds a series of subtasks that capture the steps needed to action it. In some workflows, the same piece of work passes from one person to another. Michelle categorizes each piece of feedback with a custom field. She then reassigns the feedback to the product team member who owns that category and moves it to in progress. In other cases, one task is blocking another from moving forward. These types of handoffs are a great place to add dependencies. For example, Michelle can't follow up with the teammate who submitted the feedback until she knows the outcome on the product side. So she adds a dependency between those two subtasks. In some workflows, your work intersects with another team. When you encounter an intersection, it's a good time to consider multi-homing and integrations. In Asana, tasks can be added to multiple projects at once without being duplicated. This is called multi-homing. When a feedback task gets routed to the product team, they need to keep track of it in their own development board. So Michelle multi-homes the task to that project. She's able to see updates on the task while the product team works on it. If your work intersects with another tool, check to see if an integration exists. If so, you can connect your workflow between tools. In many workflows, you'll find yourself taking the same action over and over again to move work forward. These are great places to incorporate rules, simple automations that streamline manual steps. In fact, Michelle can automate each type of movement she just added to her workflow. First, she creates a rule that automatically adds subtasks when a new piece of feedback is submitted. When she categorizes the feedback with a custom field, another rule automatically reassigns it to the right teammate. And when she moves the request to in progress, another rule multi-homes it to the product team's project. Let's watch Michelle's workflow in action from start to finish. Michelle's teammate submits a new piece of feedback using the form she created. The feedback lands as a task in her project, and the rule she created automatically adds subtasks. She updates the custom field for feedback type and moves the request to in progress. The rules she created automatically reassign the task to her teammate on the product team and multi-home the task to their development board. Michelle stays in the loop as the feedback is actioned on the product side. When it's resolved, Michelle gets notified so she can close the loop with the original submitter. And she closes the request by completing the task. All workflows in Asana are essentially composed of the building blocks and types of movement we covered in this series. Remember these key points as you're building your workflows. Start with a project. Add tasks and subtasks for actionable work. Use sections to organize the tasks in your workflow into sequences or stages. Look for initiations, handoffs, intersections, and repetition to get work flowing. And remember, workflows are dynamic, living things. You may need to make adjustments as you go. Get feedback from your teammates and host a kickoff with your team to introduce the workflow when you're ready. And that's it. You just got started with workflows. We can't wait to see what you and your team will do with them.